I'm John Marty. I'm a senior product manager at Amazon, and I have Cassandra Thompson with me. She is a career coach. She is also a YouTuber career coach. She has tons of videos on YouTube, and we have people behind us. She has tons of videos on YouTube speaking about this topic, so definitely check her out. Today, we're going to be talking about three tips to follow up after a networking event. There's a lot of questions I get on this topic, and Cassandra is the perfect person to answer this question because she works with tons of recruiters. She really understands kind of the secret sauce behind this stuff. So, tip number one, Cassandra is gonna take it away.
Yeah, so first thing you need to do is you need to send a thank you within 24 hours. So we are here at an event. I'm gonna go home today and pull out all the business cards and send each of those people just a quick two sentence note, just being like, hey, it was so nice meeting you. Mm-hmm. Thank you for that conversation. If you can remember something personal that you talked about,
absolutely.
Say thanks.
Even better, right? Just like one sentence.
Oh, I remember
that point you said, or this thing that you did. Yeah.
And same if it's a career fair. If you were at a career fair, that's a networking event, and you talked to the recruiter and they told you about their internships, just send a note saying, thanks so much for coming to our school and spending the time to talk with me. You know, I really appreciated that you said this, or, oh my gosh, I had no clue the internship included this thing. I'm even more pumped, and you'll be seeing my resume soon. Like something quick to get their attention.
Right.
And don't think because you were one of 50 people standing in that line to talk to Amazon or whatever that everybody did it.
Yeah.
They didn't.
That's right. They didn't.
So you are the one who they will remember.
It's amazing how just that tiny little bit of extra effort actually makes you stand out because nobody's doing it.
No one's doing it. So be the one.
That's right. Be the one. All right. Tip number two is follow up again, right? It's more of a continuous follow up than a first follow up, right? And this is where people kind of really don't connect the dots.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people on LinkedIn who have social media type presences, right? Whether they're on LinkedIn posting a lot of text posts or photos or whatever, they're constantly engaging. Or you have people on YouTube or Instagram, other places, right? So find them where they live, and you want to engage with their content, right? Because then you're always top of mind. Not only is nobody following up post 24 hours, but nobody literally is going the extra mile and actually making insightful comments on people's posts,
right?
And it's not trolly either.
No. Like, So after the event, you're gonna send that thank you, but we didn't say it. Find them on LinkedIn and connect too. Send both. It is not overkill to send the email. Not overkill to send the email and send the LinkedIn request. I think a lot of students in particular feel like, oh, isn't that too much? No, it's not. You need to stay connected. So then a week or two later, they post something or their company is in the news for something. Send them a direct message just saying, hey, I saw that article come out saying that you guys just launched whatever. I'm so stoked to try it.
Super exciting, right?
Like, or if they do an article, comment on their post. Now, here's the thing. They're probably not going to write back.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean they didn't appreciate
it. That's right.
It doesn't mean they didn't notice. They totally noticed, and they're going to remember.
Honestly, sometimes people reach out to me 3, 4 or more times, and it's not that I don't remember. It's just that, especially on LinkedIn, if you're a recruiter that has 50,000 connections or even 5,000 connections, right? You look at how many people that are being followed by that person, and remember that they're getting hundreds of messages, right? So you're just playing in a system where you're trying to be top of the inbox, right? You're trying to be in the comments section so that you're not necessarily in the inbox.
Yeah, definitely. And then that goes to tip three.
Tip number three. Cass is going to take it away.
Keep chatting with them and let them know when you do something new. So this one feels a little weird. Like it feels strange to go, hey, John, like send John an email and go, hey, John, I want to let you know I finally figured out Adobe Premiere.
Yeah.
Like that feels strange.
Yeah.
But if that's what he needs for someone to be an intern, cool. Now he knows I have that.
Right.
So all my recruiters have told me, I love when a student follows up and lets me know the latest thing they've done.
That's awesome.
So it's a great way to remind them of your conversation too. So, hey, at the career fair, we were talking and you said to work here, I need to have higher level C++ skills.
Yeah.
Just wanted to let you know, I just finished another course and did a project, and you can find the link to it here if you ever want to check it out. I just thought I'd share.
Yeah, it's not a hard sell.
That's
Yeah, it's not a hard sell. It's just like, hey, just letting you know, like, still pumped about the role, would love to work with you, you know.
Right, and to say, I took your advice.
Right.
And I did the thing. Y'all, if anyone tells you to build a skill, suggest a book. Says, go watch this movie or documentary.
Right.
Go do the thing.
Yeah, like, go do the thing that they told you to do, and then follow up and let them know you did it, right?
It
goes a long way.
It goes so far. Because do you know how many people they probably told, yeah, we need you to level up this skill? The ones who did it are probably this many. And then the ones who told them about it are going to be you. That's it.
That's right.
So be the one.
Be the one.
Yeah.
That's the key takeaway. Be the one, land the gig, right? Put yourself out there, and I promise you it'll pay off. I think that's all we got today.
Yeah, right? That's it.
Thanks so much, Cass, for being on the show. If you guys would like to check out her channel, please do. She's got a bunch of amazing content. Cassandra Thompson, Thompson.
Yeah, it's Cass Thompson, career advice. Come find me. Link should be in the description box.
Yep.
And I'll see you around. Thanks for having me, John.
Take care.